Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss an update from Shemaroo Kids. Shemaroo Kids.
can't seem to get enough of the trees and animals of India's treasure grove. They are willing to pay any price for them.
If we supply the stocks from there, the buyers would be very happy.
Well, if the buyers are happy, then Evelyn is happy too. India, here I come to turn your grove into a grave.
This is the notorious, infamous poacher, Evelyn. There's got to be someone to stop her from carrying out her evil intentions. Someone! Hey, that someone will be from amongst us, I'm sure. Treasure Grove, India's most beautiful forest. Everyone here lives in harmony and peace. And this is Treasure Grove Orphanage, where my good friends Krish, Mike, and Gary stay. Hey, can I share a secret with you? You know, Krish has powers given to him by Mother Earth.
I'm going in for sure.
Whoa! 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 Oh!
Ate up the soap like it was a candy bar, and he didn't even burp.
Well, there you go. Are you happy now? And this sleeping beauty won't get up even if the earth shakes. I'll just have to come up with something else.
Yeah. Think of something quick. Please, do something fast, please.
Why don't we do something that will wake him up? Chris, do you have any idea how to wake him?
I have a great idea. Here goes.
Hey, what the?
Aha.
What fun!
Mr. Biggles, let's check on poor Krish and Mike.
I love those dried and tasty figs. We must tell Gary to leave some dried figs for me too.
Okay, let's go then.
Okay, coming.
All right. Mr. Biggles, what's up?
The thing is, Mr. Biggles wanted a taste of Gary's dried figs, meaning the two of you.
Hey, Mr. Biggles, my friend!
Oh, Gary!
Wow. Oh, great. Here they come, the two great super brains of the world.
Hey, you jerk! Just sip it, okay? Unless you want me to make an omelet of your brain and feed it to Mr. Biggles!
It's always about food all the time with these guys.
Listen, Gary, I know I've only got half a brain, but only Miss Little has the right to call me a dodo. Not you. Better have a pretty good explanation for this, or I'll squeeze the eye and ha out of you right here and now. Thank you for maintaining the continuity of I. Thanks for the special effects, kid. I'll talk to Spielberg about you.
Mr. Biggles, what he means to say is you guys make a great team, like Moose and Jughead. Now do you understand what he's trying to say, you big stuffed bag?
I get it. You always say all the nicest things about me. Thanks for clearing the air around here.
Harry, put me down, will you? You silly Billy Bear. Anyway, you know I always mean that.
Considering you guys are all hanging out here, I was hoping that Gary's tummy wasn't doing a number on us again.
Hey, no, dear Snoop. We've just come here as we always do, to pray to Mother Nature, to give us the strength and courage to look after the forest and all our friends who live in it.
Strength? As in power. Good. I got you. I'm with you.
I'm not so sure that we have your support, you know. I've heard that you've been exploring the forest a lot with that girlfriend of yours. By the way, where is she anyway? Your little lollipop?
Oh, man. You really got my beatbox booming there. Oh, Chris. Oh, oh Mr. Big. I love the way she's moving. Oh, she's my beautiful girl. Oh, she's got my head spinning, my heart popping.
Oh, no. Some love stuff, Romeo, we've got here.
Looks like somebody's out there spying on us. Yeah! I got you!
Listen, you Eiffel Tower! Run, run, put your lights out and turn your neck into a lamppost!
Oh, no, 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 no! A little sugar cone won't do no harm! Say it nicely! Whoa! Whoa! Gary, Gary, if I fall down from here, I'll be the one whose lights will go out! So zip it!
Oh, my dear friend, what's the point in making fun of me? Somebody up there already did that when he made me. If this neck isn't some kind of a joke, then what is?
Hey, Hey, no, no, my dear patchwork pal. Who's the one in the forest that has such a sleek, beautiful lamppost for a neck? This way, you can always stay on top of things. Oh, whoa, 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 steady.
Sleek and beautiful, his neck.
Hey, what's the matter, Snoop? Looks like all your romantic feelings have gone up in thin air.
Hey, don't say that. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Hey, Patchy, please let him down.
Hey, Patchy, why are you so unhappy about your long neck? Nature has given each one of us our own special kind of beauty. And you have got your own uniqueness like no one else in the forest. The very neck that you're moaning about is the same one that got Snoop all shivering and shaking up there.
Yeah, thanks for the compliment, pal. You really made my day.
But the bit about the lamppost is,
Come on, guys. Let's all get together and offer thanks to Mother Nature for giving us such a beautiful environment to live in. I pledge to you, as always, Mother Nature, that I shall use the powers that you have given me only when absolutely necessary, and promise never ever to misuse them.
On my walls instead of the animals.
Oh, pray forgive us, Madam Evelyn. Just a slip of the tongue, you see. Could any mere mortal in this forest dare face you? What I mean is, thou art not just queen of this forest, but queen of the whole world. 'Tis no wonder that all the world's merchants have such implicit trust in the goods that thou sellest.
Completely true, Madam Evelyn. The demand for animal skin keeps growing along with the demand for wood. And in dishonest times like these, there is absolutely no better supplier than you.
Absolutely. You just supply us with the stuff. Don't worry about the price.
Was there ever a bargain more fair? A more opportune moment for business so fair?
Listen, Shakespeare. Why don't you stick to poetry and leave the business to me? I've had enough of your poetic prattle in my presence. Do you understand? Now, make sure you listen good and proper to what Evelyn has to say. Evelyn supplies the goods. You buy. Evelyn quotes a price you pay, or bye-bye.
Your Majesty, has there e'er been a more skillful merchant than thyself? For it is only someone as erudite as thou art that would comprehend my humble words. I am, however, prudent as I pick them in your royal presence. For I must admit, my knowledge for matters of trade is rather...
Oh, shut up, you blubbering buffoon! Or you will have to eat your own words for dinner, my dear.
Then shall I feast on them forever, for I'll warrant my words to you are eternally sweet. Why, I shall eat whatever thou offerest, for even thy most bitter fruit will be to thy humble servant like manna from heaven.
Then eat this.
Oh.
Go on, eat it. What's the matter, Fakespeare?
Oh, dare I say, some things leave a rather bitter taste in the mouth.
Hey, would you like a mouth freshener, my friend? Or something perhaps to help with the indigestion?
Silence!
Huh?
There's no need to worry about him. I'll take care of him.
Oh, okay.
As you say.
Every forest I shall destroy. Every weapon I shall employ to endanger the animals. Because this is what I enjoy.
Such eloquence, such poetry.
Shut up, shut up, shut up!
Oh, what did we?
Where are my terrible three? Do you know where they are?
Why haven't they returned yet?
Oh, your Majesty, methinks they shall be back at thy door as soon as their business is done.
I'm Hun the Hacker, and hacking is my idea of fun. I hack down any tree.
Yeah! Run, you little creatures! Run for your pathetic lives! Shotgun's coming after you, and he's got a gun!
Here you go, Mr. Biddle.
Yeah.
Bath every day, except that it's a mud bath. You know how we bears are. We just love the mud, and maybe you can't bear it. So you can't bear the bear joke, huh? How did you like my joke? Wasn't it funny?
If you will spare me your unbearable sense of humor, then maybe I will be able to bear you barely.
This jumping jack Shola, he just gives me the creeps whenever he comes around, and I don't understand why he keeps staring at me in that strange way, like I've committed a crime. I'm sure he's got some bad news as usual.
You know, it's not really his fault. You don't look like you're up to any good most of the time, especially when eating is on your mind all the time. What say, friends? If you don't zip at your shrimp, I'll squeeze whatever little air you have left out of you.
What's with you guys? Give it a break. Snoop, never mind them. Tell us, what are you so worked up about?
Dude, we've all got a reason to get worked up. Evelyn and her bad boys have been messing about the forest and ripping it apart, man. They've got our animal and bird brothers and sisters and taking them off someplace.
Oh.
Krish, man, you gotta do something about this. This is wrong.
But what's wrong with cutting trees?
Listen, you bird-brained buffoon. If we don't have trees, where are we going to get oxygen to breathe in? What's going to happen to the beautiful environment? Instead of breathing in pure oxygen, you'll choke on your deadly gas emissions.
And instead of having to suffer an agonizing death with your deadly gas emissions, I'd rather have someone wring my neck.
I've heard about this, Eveline. Oh no! Has she entered our treasure grove? We have all got to get together and do something to stop this evil woman. Maybe Maya can help us out here with her magical dancing powers.
Oh, I see. The dancing queen.
Hey guys, quit it, okay?
I see. So is she gonna do the salsa?
No, maybe she's good with hip-hop.
Guys, this is not the time for fooling around. I've got to go and meet Maya at once. Let's go.
Thank you.
Hey, what's up with this guy? Gets his face in the wrong place all the time. Miss Little, you were right. He's not a human, but an animal. They stick their faces in other people's business.
Oh God, why does this happen only with me? I was dreaming of wedded bliss, but why did it have to end like this?
Your dream came to an end, otherwise you'd keep living in the clouds and never come face to face with reality.
Where Mr. Biggles would have you for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Understood, Smarty Pants?
Oh, hey Krish, what are you guys doing here?
Is all well with y'all?
A little while ago, things were great, but not anymore. My life is a complete mess.
Why is your life a mess, my dear brother?
Brother? No!
Yes! That's what I mean by reality, dude. You've got to get real sometimes, you know?
Oh, it's nothing really, Maya. You know how he is. Besides eating and fun, fantasizing, there is little else he can do. We've actually come to discuss something very important regarding the safety of our forest.
How could anything go wrong with you being around, Krish? But if there's any way I can help, all you've got to do is ask. You know I'll do anything for you.
Oh, it's okay. Don't feel shy. We can talk about the forest problems later. And anyway, with people like Mr. Biggles and Gary running around, the forest is being depleted of its precious resources anyway.
Maya, Snoop has brought us the news that Evelyn the poacher is creating havoc in the forest and destroying it. We just have to do something to save the innocent creatures and teach this Evelyn a lesson. But for that, we need your help. If we don't do something really quick now, the future generations are bound to suffer. So it's up to us now.
Huh? Your future generation? But what about my present? My generation hasn't even begun, thanks to Mr. Biggles getting in my way.
Don't worry about a thing, Krish. I'm with you.
Oh yes, all you gotta do is ask.
And we'll do the task.
Great. We have got to put our heads together for a plan. And then everyone will have to move according to that plan. Even the slightest error on someone's part could mess things up completely. So everybody, be careful. Snoop, you sneak into Evelyn's den and just blend into her gang. And do something to provoke them to attack Treasure Grove. And to help you out, Maya, Gary, and Miss Little will also go along with you.
Yo, man! I got it! Let's go!
Oh, no! Why do I have to go along with this baboon? I don't even like looking at his face!
Gary, in that case, just focus on Maya and Miss Little. You're lucky Mr. Biggles isn't going with you. But just remember, you're going on a very important mission. So don't walk with your head in dreamland again. Otherwise, not only will you land in trouble, but get others in it too.
Maya, look after yourself.
You're only worried about Maya. We're going along too. Aren't you even bothered about us? I'm not very sure about you, you know.
Maybe you're just sending us as live bait for Evelyn?
Don't worry, guys. You'll be quite safe. I'll look after you.
That's okay, then.
All right, my jungle brothers. We got no time to waste. We gotta be kicking some serious butt from now on. We got stuff to do, so move it!
The rest of us will make our move after Evelyn's gang attacks. In this film, everyone has a very serious part to play. There will be no retakes. There is no room for any kind of mistake.
Cut! I'll rip them. My name is Evelyn the Queen, and I put the E in evil. Hey, what's your name, my little baboon?
Say what? Ha! The name's Bond. Snoop Bond. I know every kind of tree and every single breed of animal in Treasure Grove on a personal level. Which is why I'm telling you that there ain't no better place in this here world for messing around with the trees and animal hide than this here forest, yo!
It is something about his countenance and the manner of his gait that tells me he could make a veritable villain. For the villainous art of treachery. Methinks he doth truly understand as well as we do.
But stay, we have our pending orders. 'Tis imperative we make haste, lest they elude us forever, and you be brought to ruin, your highness.
Madam Evelyn, this scavenger came here with that crook bond, and has gobbled up all our dinner. We better get rid of him quick, before he rids us of our entire supplies, without even a guilty burp.
What a pathetic little whine you are. You're supposed to be guarding Queen Eveline's hideout and can't handle a little bundle like me. And don't start me on my burps. Because if you do, you'll all be blown into Burpsville.
Quiet, quiet, quiet. Who is this gaudy gate crasher?
Queen Evelyn, this is my groove gang. Know what I'm saying? This one's Mr. Alibaba, and this is Shakira. With her is Miss Bellywiener from Bollywood. We're gonna be rocking this joint tonight for you and your booty boys. Let's party! It's a party time!
Have a masquerade ball in the court of Queen Evelyn. Oh, such jollity and gaiety as never before. Splendid, splendid.
Shut up! Invite all the buyers to the Freaky Fortress tonight for a royal ball. And tonight we shall celebrate. And then tomorrow, the forest we shall devastate. I've got to complete my pending orders by tomorrow. Hacker, shotgun, Captain T. Go on out there and turn that grove into a grave like I had promised. Make sure that not a single tree or animal is spared. Understand?
Don't worry about a thing, madam. Consider it done.
No one has ever escaped my nets before, and now it's gonna be tougher.
And no cowboy in the world can match the speed of my gun.
Seize the celluloid histrionics. It's time you men carried out some action. A pestilence on thy promises. Just do as thou art told, you lazy lot.
Histrionics? I'll squeeze your neck so hard, you'll be history very soon. Always buttering up to the queen with your wisecracks. Once I'm done with the animals of the jungle, I'm going to make a doormat out of your hide.
That's a great idea. I can't wait to wipe my feet and get mud all over this slimy doormat. You old karma chameleon, you watch your tongue or I'll change your colors to black and blue with my fists right here and now.
Oh, hush, 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 hush. My dear brothers in arms, I prithee do not be hasty. I was speaking merely in jest, but you seem to have jumped the gun.
What is all this prattle I hear? Hey, you, Mr. Fakespear, stop wasting their time or I'll send you to do the work in the forest, do you understand? Now go, move it.
Haven't you heard the voice that spoke? On your way, gentlemen, for the call of the wild doth beckon, so go!
No. You want to creep? Creep now!
Hey! What's this? A hare!
You must be tired, sir. Why don't you sit down?
Sit.
I think I will. I'm starved.
Hey, why don't you eat this?
Give me, give me.
You can have one too. Oh, Gary.
Yeah! Ha-ha!
I'll cut them. I'll rip them. Those who mess with Evelyn, I'll crush them. Evelyn puts the E in evil. What were you thinking, you imbeciles? Evelyn would feel sorry for you, soothe your wounds with balm, and also give you a warm welcome. Is that it?
Your Majesty, I prithee speak not so harshly to these sorry souls, for it wounds me to the heart. What brave promises they had made ere they left, and now they return disgraced and stand before thee in shame and dishonor.
Limeborn needs to be taught a good lesson and have his tongue pulled out. I don't care if I never hunt anything more in my life, but I can't wait till I have him as a target, you see.
Oh. What on earth are you whispering about, you fools? Where were you loitering when nature was handing out brains? Tell me. Spreading out and attacking single-handedly. If you had all stayed together and attacked together, this would never have happened!
We're very sorry, Madam Evelyn. You were absolutely right. We won't let this happen ever again.
Oh, yes. Even I agree, ma'am.
We'll launch another attack tomorrow and make sure you deliver your pending orders.
Long live Queen Evelyn. Your Majesty, this Mr. Alibaba, Aga Gary, is a really good guy. And he sure loves to eat. He was on his way elsewhere when I spotted him and told him how happy you were with his performance and you would like to have another party specially for him. So he came along with me. He has told me all about his friends' plans and what they have in mind. They do have some great ideas.
Dear Mr. Alibaba, tax not thy mind with mere matters of food, for you are more than welcome to all of the leftovers of my plate. Why dost thou not invite thy friends to our lavish banquet?
I see. Okay, my loyal hound. Do be so kind as to go and inform his sweet friends that Mr. Alibaba is our very special guest, and that we would love to invite them to the banquet too. All right? Now go.
Krish, Queen Evelyn has requested an audience with you and your friends to discuss the future of the forest. Your dear friend Gary has told us all about the excellent plans you have in mind. Madam Evelyn is very impressed with all of you and would very much like to meet you.
Okay. I knew that greedy slob would get us into trouble one day because of his food obsession. When I get my hands on him, I'll make sure that I'll puncture that bloated belly of his.
Madam Evelyn, I just heard that you have decided to mend your evil ways. Great, better late than never. We are all really very glad to hear that.
Hello, Krish, my son. You know, if only I had been married in time, I would have had a dear little boy just like you of my very own by now. But alas. But it's never too late, you see. You can still live here, with me in my cave as my son. You'll be prince of all the forest and its creatures. And you can have your friends here too, if you like.
Now, isn't that a capital idea, my young prince? You shall enjoy much merriment for the rest of your days in here, and thou shalt have all that thy heart desires. And besides, thou shalt converse with the very finest of merchants.
Hey, what do you say, younger man? We can all be lords of the forest. Is that the deal? You agree?
It's because of greedy buyers like you that Evelyn has this need for destruction. Even if you offered me the wealth of the whole world in exchange for this forest, I would throw it in your face. And Madam Evelyn, you better watch your step. Because if you and your men do not stop your vandalism, then me and my gang will get together and kick you so hard that we'll bat you off into eternity. And yes, if you really feel the pangs for parenting, why don't you adopt the innocent animals of the forest instead of endangering their lives?
Listen, Krish, if you're not interested in being a son, then speak for yourself.
Mommy, dearest, I'll be your long-lost son. I know I shall enjoy the food of your table. Mommy, Mommy, please, do not break my heart and say no.
Don't you ever think about anything besides food? If you hang around here for even 1 minute instead of enjoying her food, you'll be dog food yourself very soon. And whatever's left of your thick skin, she'll sell it to these buyers.
Oh, that's all right, Krish. Maybe you won't understand me right away. You're a little upset, aren't you? Go on. Go home and think about it when you're in a calmer frame of mind. Go.
Let's go now.
What? Madam Eveline, what's this you've done? You let the sitting ducks escape?
Truly, you lot must have had something very important to do when they were handing out brains, I think. You imbeciles. Can't you see how Evelyn's mind works? If we held those kids hostage in here, their friends would create a lot of trouble and get in the way of our mission. And the most important thing right now is to meet the demands of all our buyers. Those brats are completely unaware. They cannot even imagine that we're about to launch another attack. Hacker, shotgun, Captain T, get ready. We shall attack the jungle without any further delay and teach those brats a lesson for insulting Queen Evelyn. Our forest must be destroyed.
Wonderful, Your Majesty. What an excellent plan. I wonder why I never get such divine inspiration myself.
Because you've got nothing but air in that brain of yours. And that is why I am queen. And you're just a court jester.
Now, as a matter of principle, we first always request, then we try explaining. And if they still don't get it, we teach them a good lesson. And that means attack.
Meaning?
It means, if they don't like something sweet, we offer them something spicy.
Meaning? Now I get it. It means Krish has got two very special dishes that he's hiding from us. But if you're his friend, why is he hiding them from you?
Forget about it. I beg of you. I don't even know why I'm trying to explain.
When one airhead tries to teach another airhead, all we end up with is lots and lots of gas, isn't it?
You're all such a bunch of losers. Even in times like these, you're at each other's throats. Look, just look at the state of the forest and its creatures thanks to that witch. I mean, wicked witch Eveline. Krish, you're the only sensible one. You've got to come up with something very soon. Why don't you think of a plan and we'll all follow your orders?
Oh, where's Krish and the gang? Are they here?
Thank you.
Snoop, what news do you have for us? And why are you looking so worked up?
Two questions? Two answers. It's too much to ask. Give me a break, man. Answer number one. Evelyn has captured all the animals of the forest. And she's about to hand them over to her buyers at the old freaky fortress. But before she does that, she's planning to take revenge on all of us and destroy the forest completely. Answer two. She's got my girl in there with her.
What's wrong with him? I think he's finally lost it.
Oh, man, what am I gonna do? She's gonna do some monkey business with my girl. Oh, please, you gotta help me, man. They're gonna stuff my girl with all kinds of food, and she's just gonna die if she doesn't fit into size zero again. I can't think of it. I can't. Oh, no.
I know that girl of yours too well. Always up to some monkey business. While you're busy bursting your tear ducts here, I bet she's trying her monkey tricks on someone else out there who's stuffing her with food.
Snoop, don't you worry about a thing. We'll definitely get your girlfriend, along with all our other animal friends, out of this safe and sound.
Yeah, that won't be a problem at all. Even if we are unable to rescue her, Gary will make sure that he takes full advantage of the opportunity to play knight in shining armor.
Hey, wait a minute. My Miss Little also went along to meet your monkey girlfriend. Where is she?
But didn't you say that she was going to meet some other friend? Why did she go to meet Snoop's girl?
Actually, you know, she had gone to meet Snoop's girlfriend to make some secret plans for a picnic. So that we could get a little, you know, more romantic.
Oh, I think you better put the romance on hold, dude. I'm sorry, but it slipped my monkey brain completely that Evelyn's men have got hold of Miss Little, too. I heard that she was willing to give her own life to save the life of my sweet girlfriend. Oh,
Evelyn, if you harm my Miss Little, then you are dead meat. I'm coming for strawberry.
Strawberry? But I always thought you hate strawberries.
Yeah. Yes, I do, but she loves strawberries. You don't know anything about love, kid. Whenever I get kinda sentimental, you see, I get all romantic and call her my strawberry. And that's how our love works as well. Cause when she gets emotional, she likes to call me her puffy muffin. And I just love muffins. So together we love strawberry muffins. And our other emotions? All our other emotions are same to same.
Now listen, we have really got to watch out for this Evelyn. She has managed to beat us at her own game. We have got to stand united once again if we all want to fight her. But before she thinks of launching another attack on us, we have got to squash her game as quickly as possible.
Yes.
Snoop and Mr. Biggles, you guys go and get all your animal buddies together. We have got to first think of a way to free our captive friends. And then we take on Evelyn and her men, beat them up, and chase them out of here forever.
I wonder how my poor little Mr. Biggles is faring without me. I wonder if he's had anything to eat at all.
What if he loses his jiggly jelly belly worrying about me? No!
So that's it. We launch our second attack on the forest. But this time, we get hold of Krish and all his pesky friends as well. Then there will be no one left in this forest who would dare mess with Queen Evelyn ever again!
Your Majesty, must thou waste thy time fighting these mere babies? And as I recall, we do have one of their friends captive already, don't we? If we take it easy for a while and lie low for a few days, I'm sure things will sort themselves out and we'll have peace ere long, don't you agree?
I'll have peace. I'll cut them. I'll rip them. I won't have peace till I peace all of them. I know what to do. Listen, I want you to continue threatening Miss Little with her life. She's not to have even a moment's peace. And you three, go get all the men together. This time, we are going to attack like never before.
I think this is the best opportunity for you to rake in the supplies and sell them to us, so you can rake in the moolah and add to your treasury.
Mr. Fakespear. You don't have to worry as long as Madame Evelyn is around. Just put away your Shakespeare for once and fight.
What say my brothers? This time, Mr. Fakespear is going to be using a real spear.
Now, isn't that rather impetuous?
What?
Well, of course, I'd lay down my life for Her Majesty in the blink of an eye. But wouldn't it be more judicious I stay back here with her and defend her and ward off any possible assault on her royal personage, which of course I shall do with one heave of my solid chest.
Looks more like a chest of drawers to me. What's it, boys?
Drawers that have got nothing in them, you know what I mean? Empty drawers.
There are guards there.
Yeah.
been so long. I missed you so much, girl. I was kind of getting at the end of my tail, honey.
Listen, doofus. Save the Romeo Juliet act till you get home. If you hang around here for even one moment more, they'll have both your hearts on a platter for Eveline's dinner.
Everyone move towards the valley. Our friends have gathered there already and are waiting for us. Today we shall drive Eveline and her men out of this forest forever.
Madam, just wanted to know, half our order has come in. When will the other half come?
Very soon.
Madam Eveline, Krish and his friends have rescued all the animal prisoners from their cages.
Oh, no.
And not only this, along with all their other forest friends, they are planning a major attack on us at any moment now.
This Krish does not give up, does he? Now the fun begins, and we shall all enjoy ourselves. The spider didn't have to go very far to find the fly. He has walked right into her web.
Alas, madness has got my lady. Speak not of flies and spiders, for I can feel the noose tightening down her neck already.
My friends, the time has finally come that we take a stand towards a better future and defend our beloved forest from Evelyn and her men. We'll drive out these enemies of the environment forever.
Thank you.
have my revenge. Every tree and creature, I shall destroy what Evelyn cannot possess. Evelyn will terminate!
And you think that the destruction of the forest will not have an effect on you? Just like everyone else in the world, you do need the forest to provide air for you to be there.
Did you get us to fight in the first place, huh?
Maybe you should always share your rather deep thoughts only with our dear Gary, since both of y'all are pretty much in the same non-existent wavelength.
Well, didn't I tell you it would be one of us to set things right? And we did it!
Thank you.
kids. Hope you liked the video.
Subscribe for more fun videos.